Yo, what up? It's your boy Cage in the basement, man. Let's get it. Street Hems versus Luke Castro. PG Spotlight. Let's talk about it. Now, off rip, I just want to say this. Shout out to both of these brothers, man, for their PG battle, the first one I ever seen. They put on, they did their thing. But I'm going to say again, Norbs, P, Smack, whoever in charge, Beasley, whoever in charge of the PG process, can we please this year get a little bit more structure to the PG process? Like, at least a list to know who just made the PGs as rookies, who's still in the PGs battling, and who graduated from the PGs. I think that shit is important now. That structure will add more structure to what y'all doing. And also, there need to be a top-tier structure like rookies, mid-tiers, and top-tiers, super top-tiers, guard-tiers, whatever y'all want to do. There needs to be a listed tier structure that needs to have access to it on y'all's site. I think that should be real dope. You know what I mean? Battle rappers get mad at what tier they get placed in, whatever. But that tier, the tiering system being stamped this year will add more validity to battle rap, a better way to keep stats, and champion just prove, shout out the champion, that stats is needed, it's important. So let's get into it. PG Spotlight. Now off rip, I never heard of neither one of these dudes, man. I ain't gonna hold you. I ain't seen none of them battle yet. So I ain't know what to expect going into this battle. But round one, you got your boy Street Hems. Now, obviously, I think he wanted a Four Horsemen because I seen him with Loso, Saga, and all the other dudes from the Four Horsemen. So that was kind of obvious for me. Then getting into your boy, Luke Castro, I seen him. He with the Goonies. So I think that's dope. I think the Goonies and the Four Horsemen should battle a lot more often. Those two crews is a perfect clash, man. I like that shit. I like when they be going at each other and all that. I think Loso and Twerk will be dope, all that else shit. But anyway, another thing I want to say about this battle, as soon as I seen Street Hems, I immediately recognized his style. And that's not even a good thing in round one. Now, he wasn't bad, but the way he was performing, he was using this whole word association. You know, like, you know what I did before? Nah, I said 1, 2, 3, 4. I don't really like that style. That shit is getting played out. Like, his bars is dope. His content is dope and creative with the whole Christianity thing. I think it's needed. But he really, really need to figure out an original style to present that shit. Because that whole word association thing you doing, you, Loso, A Ward, and Saga ain't gonna all be able to get away with that word association shit. One of y'all gonna have to switch it up. At least you. Then moving on. I was fucking with his first round. It was clean. He was doing his thing. He was a little awkward with the performance, but I wasn't too mad at it. And then we got your boy, Luke Castro. Now, off rip, same thing with him. Soon as he started rapping, I said, yo, I recognize this style. And it wasn't a good thing. I immediately was like, yo, the boy is moving like Twerk. And that's when I noticed that the Goonies is right there. So I said, all right, obviously, that's Twerk, man. So I don't know. What y'all think about that? I don't think it really matters because this is how I took it. At first, I'm like, I recognize the style. But as the battle went on, and by the time I got to the end of the battle, I'm like, all right, now, it looks more like he's the originator of the style more than a copy of the style, if that makes any sense. It looked like he created the style, and we just saw Twerk first. That's how I felt immediately by the end of the battle. So anyway, I still think something was dope. Like, his bars was fire. Like, you could clearly see the big difference between him and Street Hems. Like, he looked like he's in a graduating class of the PGs, and Street Hems look like he belong in a freshman class. Like, they both belong in the PGs, but you could clearly see, like, it's like a freshman beating up on a rookie. That's how I look. He looks seasoned and like he ready to go for the main stage, and he looked like he needed a couple of more battles. And he even said, like, a couple of his battles got vaulted, and, like, there's no way to know how many PGs the boy had. If he's he could be a senior PG member on his way to graduate. That counts. That's a stat for him. So, yeah, over at round one, I'm giving that to Luke Castro, especially with that lean on the body, smooth criminal line. Like, the way he performed that, like, that's what I'm saying. Like, he got all his cadences. Everything is fully together for the boy. I was fucking with it all the way. Then you got round two. Now, round two, the boy mentioned about how, you know, he rapped like Twerk. And that's when I was like, yep, there you go. Him and Twerk is best friends. They definitely alike. I knew I wasn't bugging. But he was getting it out. I was fucking with that angle. The angle was hitting. But it didn't look like he was fazed by it. Because obviously, he probably thinking in his head, nigga, this is my style. So I don't care if you say I stole it. It's my shit. So he didn't look fazed by it. But I think the angle hit. It was even surprising to some people look like. But then the boy, Hems, Hems end up choking. Now, I'm going to tell you now, it's never good to choke in your first battle, man. And your boy just said every nigga that stood in front of him fucking throws up. And you choked, man. It was kind of a, it was a bad choke, man. It was a choke, man. Well, no matter if it was good or bad, it was a clean choke. You choked. You got it back together. You closed it up, but you choked. That round, you choked that round. So off rip, I'm like, damn, Lou Castro might be cleaning this kid up. So he comes out round two. And he does exactly what I kind of expected him to do. Like, he cleans you up. But the boy was fire, though. Like, he added a lot more to his style. He was doing a lot, like, moving around. Like, I was really fucking with a lot that he was doing on that stage. Like, he looked really ready for this shit. Like, I could already picture a couple of good matchups for the kid. Like, he doing his thing. I'm fucking with the boy, Lou. I like his content, too. Like, he like Twerk with the like, I'm gonna keep comparing him to Twerk. Not only they performance and projection and delivery and the way they be bouncing, but it's more like he got the haymakers from left field where it's not predictable setups. And that shit is starting to stick to me. I like all the niggas that got unpredictable setups. I'm fucking with, man. All of them, basically. That's the new shit, man. Y'all niggas better learn how to be unpredictable, man. How to catch a nigga off guard with that counterpunch, man. They don't even see coming. I need to add that to y'all repertoire. All of y'all niggas, man. Twerk is innovating that whole style, that counter punch, Rum Nitty too. Punching from left field, you don't even see it coming type shit. That shit's fire. So yeah, he was doing that round two. I was fucking with that. Then we get into round three. The boy, I ain't gonna hold you. Now this round, Street Hems, he got less away from that word association. Again, he started being himself. It looked like he was not trying to emulate a style. He was just being himself. Like, for instance, he had the anime bars talking about how this is who I am. Like, I rocks with this. I don't give a fuck if you rock with this. He talking about my hero. All this ill anime shit that I know niggas be watching. Niggas be trying to feel like, I don't watch that. I don't watch that. Who cares, man? It's still fire. If you don't watch it, you probably should. The shit is fire. Most of that anime shit nowadays is fire. Oh, anime is for kids. So what, man? Who cares what you think it's for, nigga? Watch it or don't. But that shit is fire. All them anime bars, I be rocking with it. So, I like the nigga Hems in round three. I think that style that he came into at the end of the battle is the style that'll help him move forward in the PG process. And he'll definitely get some bigger battles. So, shout out to you. You had three good rounds. You choked in the second, but it was still a decent round, even though you choked. I still got you losing this battle, but this is the weird part. Now, he had a good third round, right? Then you got the boy Lou Castro come out, and I guess he decided to have a real nigga or a real talk third, and he wrote his bars, and he started talking about a personal issue, and I guess the perfect person to talk to it about is somebody that know God, like, so he want to ask God, because that, I don't even want to bring it up, that shit was sad, bro, I ain't gonna hold you, like, I know a lot, I've been through that, I know a lot of people out there have been through that, those moments is the most difficult moments of a nigga life, man, trust me, man. So I felt you, man. I know you was heartfelt. And I'm going to say this. You choked, but you choked up. It's not like you was forgetting your shit. I seemed like you was just choking up, like trying to stop yourself. You probably was about to cry or something, man. And I was just hoping you don't cry or nothing, man. Because I know your bars was going to be fire. And I ain't even take no points away. You know what? You choked, but I didn't take away points like you forgot your shit or you got nervous. Like, you just choked up. It was a real touchy moment, so I ain't really take that many much points away from you. You already won the battle, really. So, it wasn't too bad, but I'm still giving Hems round three because I did take away a few points for that little choke up. And Hems came into his own in his round three, and your round three was still good, but Hems shit, he edged you round three, just straight up. So I'm giving the battle 2-1. Y'all, both of y'all brothers, put on. That's what I'm talking about. Keep doing this shit. Keep releasing these PG battles, man. We got to see these shit. We got to let these brothers know how they doing, man. And you already know what it is. Your boy Cage in the building. We in a fucking basement. Ground up shit. Bottom to the top. You already know what it is. Yeah, nigga.